Unlike online search engines like Google, the library has different searching systems for different types of resources. In this video, we'll be looking at one of the library's databases, PsycInfo. Instead of starting in OneSearch, we often recommend students start in a database, especially if they're in the beginning stages of their research and haven't fully decided upon a scope or a focus for their assignment. Many students begin their research here, using the library's OneSearch feature. When you're looking for academic articles, however, OneSearch can be an overwhelming place to start because you may end up with hundreds of thousands or even millions of results. Instead of starting in OneSearch, we often recommend students start in a database. In this video, we'll be using one of the library's article databases, PsycInfo. A full list of the library's databases can be found in the Articles and Databases tab. If you click on the Databases by Subject option and scroll down, you'll see PsycInfo is the eighth option in the Popular Databases box. PsycInfo covers psychology and the psychological aspects of related disciplines such as medicine, psychiatry, nursing, sociology, education, pharmacology, and physiology. It has hundreds of thousands of articles, many of which are peer-reviewed or academic, and it is a great starting point for almost any psychology research assignment. To connect to the database, click on the name of the database. If you're off campus, you will be asked to log in at this point before you can proceed into the database. On the initial page you land on, you can enter your keywords or phrases right away and then hit search and see what results you get. You can also set some limits on this page, including finding only peer-reviewed or academic resources, setting a date range, or searching for a specific document type. In PsycInfo, you can also choose a type of methodology to limit your results to, which allows you to limit to only qualitative or quantitative studies, literature reviews, empirical studies, and many others. All of these limiting options are also available on your results page. Let's say you're looking for academic articles about how caregiving affects mental health. When we search in the library's databases, it's important to remember to use only keywords or phrases, not full sentences or questions. To start my search, I'll try entering caregiving into the first search box and mental health into the second search box. I'll click search and see what I get. This search gives me over 4,000 results. And now it's time for me to see if the keywords I chose are the best ones for me to use for this research topic. As I scroll through the first few articles, I'm looking at the article titles and the subjects listed. These will give me clues as to if I'm using the correct vocabulary and if my results are related to my topic. Looking through the listed subjects, I start to see a different term used instead of caregiving. Caregivers. I'm going to add this term to my search box using OR. OR is a Boolean operator that broadens or expands your search by requiring that either term be present, giving you more results. I can see that I now have over 20,000 results. While we do want to eventually narrow our search down, it's important that we start with a pool of results that include as many related resources as possible. I can continue to modify my search terms, or I can set some limits on my search first. On the left side of the screen, there is a Limit To menu. Using this menu, I can limit my results to only peer-reviewed, refereed, or scholarly resources. Check this box if your assignment requires academic articles. I can also limit to articles that the library currently holds in its collection by clicking Full Text. Additionally, I can add a date range to my results list. This is especially important if you want to find recent research. You'll see that my results list contains resources published between 1846 and 2020. If you're researching a more recent topic or want more recent research, Typically applying a 10 or even a 5-year range is a good idea. Below the Limit To menu, I have a list of source types, which will allow me to choose to see results from only academic journals or books or whatever you choose. And in Psych Info, I can apply a methodology limiter. By clicking on this arrow, I'll see that in this search, for example, I have several types to choose from, including empirical studies, quantitative studies, and literature reviews. I'm going to add the following limits: peer-reviewed, full text, 2010 to 2020, and for methodology, I'm going to limit to only empirical studies, and I'm going to see what happens to my results list. Once I add all of those limiters, my results list drops down to about 6,400 results. At this point, I can continue to modify my search terms, or I can try adding a new search term to further narrow my research. I'm going to add a population to my search and look for research to see if there are differences between different genders in this topic. In my third search box, I'm going to add gender or gender differences. When I hit search, I see that I now have just over 500 results. At this point, I can either continue to modify my search terms, or I can start looking through my results list to see if I can find articles that will work for my assignment. When I added my third search term in, I lost my methodology limiter. If I add that back in, my results are further reduced to just over 400. As you do your research and find articles that you may want to look at further, be sure to add them to a folder that you can then email to yourself. To find out more information about an article, you can click on the article's title, which will lead you to its record. In an article's record, you'll find the information you need to cite the article and an abstract that gives an overview of what the article is about. You'll also see some database tools, including print, email, and cite. The database-generated citation can be a good starting point, but please remember that your citations are your responsibility, and you must ensure that they are correct before handing them in. For more citation resources, please check out the library's Cite Your Sources page. One last tool that you can find in this database is the Ask Away widget. Ask Away is our virtual reference service, and when it is open, you can simply type into the chat box where it says type here to chat, and a librarian will answer you within about 60 seconds. If Ask Away is closed, its hours will be displayed in the box. Please don't hesitate to use Ask Away, as your librarians are always happy to help you with your research. The Douglas College Library has millions of resources for you to use for your Douglas College courses, many of which you can access online from your home. Please check out our videos and tutorials for more detailed instructions or contact a librarian for help.